Hello, and welcome to this episode of Piping Up, presented by the Tabernacle Choir at Temple Square. Our organist today is Brian Mathias, and I'm your host, Luke Howard. This organ recital is a little different from the usual. Let's call it a best of the rest show. Most of the works on Brian's program today have been selected from the list of most frequently requested works that haven't yet been performed on Piping Up. We're filling in some of the gaps, in other words. So we begin with the trumpet tune of Fred Swann, well known to many as a past president of the American Guild of Organists and a beloved teacher and composer recognized for his modesty and generosity. Dr. Swann is now 90 years old and continues to play organ at his local church in Palm Desert, California. Then we'll hear the jaunty Marche militaire by Franz Schubert. It was originally composed for piano duet, but it's heard today in the organ transcription by Harry Vibbard, a renowned early 20th century organist at Syracuse University in upstate New York.
Thank you.
For at least the last 200 years, the word sentimental has mainly been used pejoratively, an exaggerated reliance on shallow emotions in place of rational thought. It wasn't always that way. In the middle of the 18th century, sentimentality, or the ability to experience and value a broad range of emotions, was often praised as evidence of virtue, a heart unnumbed by worldliness or cynicism. It meant something along the same lines as sensible or sensitive. All these words derive from the same Latin root, the ability to feel. Then, in the 19th century, moral philosophers started to be suspicious of sentimentality. There is no truth in emotion, they claimed. Truth resides only in objective reason. By the end of the century, the famed author Oscar Wilde summed up this belief by claiming, "A sentimentalist is one who desires to have the luxury of an emotion without paying for it." Clearly, it's possible to go too far in either direction. It would be foolish to think we can navigate the minefields of life's complexities, relying just on poignant nostalgia and greeting card platitudes. And by the same token, a life void of emotion is clinical and cold. Even more sad is when someone is incapable of experiencing any kind of spiritual impulse because they are, as it's sometimes termed in Christian scripture, past feeling. Their soul has become so hardened that nothing tender or comforting can reach them. It's good to check in with our emotions occasionally and remember what it's like to feel, so that we can remain open to those impressions that move our souls and spirits. A little nostalgia and a little sentimentality is healthy every now and then, and it can be an antidote to a world filled with cynicism and irreverence. The next work on today's program comes from a period when sentimentality was tolerated a little more freely in society, and when organ music enjoyed a more prominent place. So let's go back to 1948 with Ralph Kinder's popular and quaintly nostalgic character piece, In Springtime. This is the part of Piping Up where we honour tradition instead of viewer requests. Brian will play his own arrangement of the Latter-day Saint hymn, Come, Come Ye Saints, which Temple Square organists have been doing for well over a century now. And then he'll perform his arrangement of All Things Bright and Beautiful, a sprightly melody that was a country dance long before it was used as a hymn tune. In fact, this melody was first adapted to a hymn text in 1915, which in the history of hymnody is virtually last week. First though, Come, Come Ye Saints. Marcel Dupré may have been one of the 20th century's best organ improvisers, and his virtuoso technique was unsurpassed. Interesting then that his Cortège et Litanie was written originally in 1921 for piano, and then arranged by Dupré for organ with orchestra when it was adapted as incidental music for a play in 1922. Dupré himself finally published the Cortège et Litanie in a version for solo organ in 1924. He kept the orchestral colors in the transcription, which explores the full range of a large symphonic instrument such as the tabernacle organ. A cortège is simply a solemn processional, and a litany is a series of repetitions of a single motif that draws its power from the accumulated recurrences. Slow and stately, then animated counterpoint based on one theme. Dupré could easily have titled this Cortège et Litanie a prelude and fugue, and it wouldn't be far off the mark. We're so glad you joined us for today's episode of Piping Up featuring Brian Mathias. Thank you for watching. You are always welcome to return for the weekly live stream of these concerts, and previous episodes are also available for on-demand viewing. More information about this program, including a link to submit listener requests, can be found at tabchoir.org/pipingup. Piping Up, Organ Concerts at Temple Square, streams live every Wednesday at noon Mountain Time on the Tabernacle Choir's website and YouTube channel, and at broadcasts.churchofjesuschrist.org.